Awesome Challenge. I'm excited. We are officially halfway done with the challenge. Hey, so before we get started, let me make this quick announcement. I am excited because tonight, 8 p.m. sharp, I am doing a webinar, a free webinar that where I will give you tips on how to survive Thanksgiving without all the extra weight gain. Okay, so make sure that you sign up for that. The link is below and in this post. So I'm excited. I cannot wait to share my tips with y'all. I was working on the webinar last night, and so I'm really excited to give you all these great and awesome tips. So let's get started with today's workout. Uh-oh. We're going up in numbers. We are adding back in the Tone It Up challenge. So today, I keep saying so, right? So today we are doing the wall sit challenge, the Tone It Up challenge, and also the Tammie challenge. How many of you realized that yesterday I forgot one of the exercises in the Tammie challenge? I forgot to do squats. So I hope you remember and you did your 10 squats. I won't forget today though. Let's get started. Everybody find a wall. I'm gonna get the timer here. Hopefully the timer won't cut off today. Back is up against the wall. Lower back is against the wall. If you need to step your legs out pretty far, you can also do this challenge with your legs spread a little bit wider. I like to do mine with my legs closer. So let's get in our position. I'm going to turn on our timer. We are doing wall sit for 2 minutes and 30 seconds. I do have something I want to talk to you about today. We are going to go ahead and get in this position, lower down against the wall. Remember, the farther out your legs are, less pressure's on your knees. Okay, I'm going down, going down, going down. Back is flat against the wall. As you can see, I'm not parallel, I'm not down here. This will affect my knees. So I'm up just a little bit more on the wall. Let's get started. There we go. So I have had someone that actually did post when I asked, what do you need help with? And she mentioned that she wanted me to create a video that dealt with how to stress eat. So I'm not going to talk about that now, but be on the lookout for that video. But today, I want to give you this tip, which is, how do you avoid eating junk food and snacks late at night? So some of you are probably stay up late, you're night people, whatever you want to call it, night owls. I am not, right? So 7:30, 7:45, I am sleepy. Oh my God, because I am going to bed at 8 o'clock. But I will tell you that last night, while working on the project and staying up a little bit later than I usually do, I did start having cravings. Like, I wanted chips and junk food and candy. Thank goodness I had no candy here. I do have chips for when I have a free meal, a free day, but I did not open them. It was really, really hard. So I'm telling you, it was hard for me to do. But I passed the test. I kept coming in the kitchen and get something, and I said, no, you're not going to eat that today, right? So one of the things you can tell yourself is, I'm not going to eat that today. I can have that any day I want, just not right now, not today. Another thing that you can do is, one of the things I do if I have really bad cravings, I just go to bed. Like, I go get into bed, and I go to sleep. So that will end all those cravings right there, going to sleep. You can do that if you can. Another thing that I would love to suggest for you to do is to find a healthy snack. So at the event that I have in March, but I actually had it again this year in September, we have 1 minute left. So I had a speaker come, and oh my gosh, she made this delicious dish with berries. It was so good. So here's what the recipe is. It's any berries that you want, blueberries, raspberries, strawberries. You clean them with apple cider vinegar. You put them into a bowl. And then after you put them into a bowl, you can add like slivered almonds for the crunchy factor. You can put honey in, a little bit of honey. That takes care of the sweet that you may be having. The fruit takes care of the sweet that you may be having. And the other thing that she added in was dark chocolate chips, right? So you can add a few of those in. And actually, that probably gives you a little crunch, sort of like a crunch, but it also gives you a sweet. So you don't have to have the chocolate chips. But she did add the chocolate chips in for us. I mean, she didn't add the chocolate chips in for us at all, right? So the timer went off again. So that's okay. We're good. So that is another thing that you can do. Also, to have a healthier snack if you want something, you know, like something sweet, something crunchy, that kind of would satisfy those things that you're looking for. Okay, so we have, give me 1 second. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's it. Great job, everyone. What's going on with this thing today? Okay, so next, we are going to go ahead and do our tone it up exercises. So I really hope those tips help you. If you end up wanting something late at night, like some junk food or something like that. So try to do a tip because we're going to be doing the exercises longer. So let me stop talking. All right. Today we're doing 7 burpees. We're doing 14 squats, 7 push-ups, and we have a minute and 30 seconds on the plank. Again, anything that we do, please feel free to alternate it to fit whatever you need to do. If it's time, can't do it the whole time, that's fine. If you need to take a break, that's fine, and jump back in. You can't do all of the reps, that's fine. Do what you can, okay? We are a lot stronger than we were 16 days ago. Burpees, 7 burpees. So, I'll do a variety of them for you, just so that you have, so that you can do different things. Everybody can't do a full burpee. But the first thing I am going to do is a full burpee. Let's get started. Down. I'm jumping back in plank position. I'm jumping up and then jump to the ceiling. Down, I'm going to step back. I'm going to do a mountain climber. I'm going to step up. I'm going to stand up and squeeze. So when I stand up, I'm squeezing, right? Go down. Abs are tight at all times. I'm going to step back. How about this? 1, 2, 3, 4. Step up, stand up, and squeeze. That's 3. I'm going to go down. I'm going to jump back. Go on my knees, push up, come on my toes, walk up. That's 4. Go down. Step back. Hold this plank. Step up, knees high. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 5. 2 more. Let's go down. Jump back. Push up. Jump up. Stand up. That's 6. Last one, full burpee. Go down. Jump back. Push up. Come up. Jump up. That's 7. Okay, I hope y'all were able to do at least one or a couple of those alternatives today. Next is squats. And we are doing 14 squats. Remember, the action is in the standing as you squeeze. Make sure you're sitting back when we go down. Let's go get started. Down. Here's my position. I'm sitting back. Stand up and squeeze. Tight. Squeeze tight. Down. Squeeze tight. That's 3. Squeeze tight. Now, for those of you that are looking to lift up your butt, squeeze. That's 5. Or you're looking to make it a little bigger, that's 6. Make sure you're squeezing your legs and your butt at the same time. 7. Down. 8. Down. 9. You can also grab you some hand weights. 10. When we do these. 11, 12, or if you have a kettlebell, 13, you would just hold it, 14, great job. Now it's time to go to the floor. We're going to do our push-ups. And today, we are doing 7 push-ups, and then we also have to do our 1.5 minute plank. Okay, so 7 push-ups. I'll do different alternative ones today just so you see them in case you forgot. I'm going to go on my toes first. See how my shoulder, elbow, wrist are aligned? I'm doing this with my elbows in. Let's abs are tight. You can squeeze your legs and butt. Go down. Come up. That's one. I'm going to drop my knees. Stay in the same position. Just continue to make sure my shoulder, elbow, wrist are aligned. Let's go down. That's two. I'm going to now come back some so that I'm like here. Shoulder and elbow, wrist still aligned. Back is not arched like this. Back is pulled up. Abs are tight. And I'm going to just do this. That's three, right? So it's just this. I'm going to take my arms out wide. Kind of close to the wall here. Take my arms out wide. I'm going to go down. That's four. Let's go. I think that's all of them. You can use the wall and use a chair. So, three more. Any way you want. I'm going to do this. Five. Six. And seven. Great job, everyone. Now we're doing a 1.5 minute plank. You can go on your arms, your elbows, your knees. I'll show you different alternative ways to do this. So let's go ahead and get started. 1 minute plank, 1.5 minute, let's go. So if you're here, make sure you're breathing. Abs are tight, your hips are up. I'm gonna move my wrist up some so my elbow is aligned with my shoulder. Make sure you're breathing. I'm gonna come up on my hands. And just breathe. Concentrate on something else, not the time. Ha! Now, if you begin to hurt, you can always do a plank this way. Keeping your abs tight, still breathing. Going back up here. You can use the chair also. So breathe. I know this is difficult. It's getting hard for me. We have 30 seconds left. But we can do it. You can move your legs. See, my back isn't arched though. Keep holding on if you can. If you need to take a break, take one. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's it. Great job, everyone. Let's go ahead and start with our 10 jumping jacks. So, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alternative, 7, 8, 9, 10. Woo! I'm starting to sweat in here. All right. Next is our squats. I forgot these yesterday. I won't forget them today. We're doing 10 squats. Abs tight. Remember, tight abs. Squeeze your butt. Squeeze your legs. So let's go. Down. One. Down. Two. Down. Three. Down. Four. Down and squeeze. Five. Down. Six. Sit back. Seven. Don't let your knees go over your toes, okay? And squeeze. That's nine. One more. 10. Great job, everyone. So now we're going to go ahead and go back on the floor. We have to do push-ups and crunches and our oblique crunch as well, right? So, let's start with push-ups. Go ahead and do our push-ups first. I just did a bunch of alternatives for push-ups. So we have 10 of these to do. I'm going to do half of them in the regular position, and I'll do alternatives for you. Squeeze your butt. Back is not arched. Abs and pull tight.
Let's go. Down. One. Two. Three. Four. Five.
I want you to go as low as you can.
On my elbow, I mean on my knees now. Let's go. Down. Six. Down. Seven. Now just the pulses. I'm gonna come back some. This is eight. Nine. Hands are wide. Still in my elbows and my knees. Go down. Ten. Okay. Now let's flip over. We got 10 crunches. And we have 10 oblique crunches. I'm going to do something different for oblique crunches today. So, let's do our regular crunches first. Elbows are out to the side, hands behind your head. Pretend like there's a tennis ball between your chin and your neck. Don't move it. Look up to the ceiling. Crunch up. Hold. Breathe out at this point. Down. Up. Two. Down, up, three, up, four, my shirt on zip, up, five, up, six, lower back stays on the floor, eight, breathe out, nine, breathe out, and 10. Great job, everyone. Now, what I want you to do for the obliques is we're actually going to twist to the side like this when we're laying down. And we're going to try and touch our heels, okay? So left, right is one. Okay, so here we go. Let's go. This way is one, okay? This way, two, three, four, five. Make sure you're breathing out. Six, seven. Abs are tight. Eight. Nine, 10. Woo! So, great job, everyone. As a reminder, if you have not signed up for the webinar for tonight, that's free. Make sure you do so. The link is in this post. Also, make sure you join me on social media. You can find me on Facebook at Chevy Williams. You can also find me on Pinterest, Instagram, and Twitter at LBX Fitness. Also, visit my website, www.leadingbyexample.us, for more great tips on health, wellness, and fitness. I will see everyone tomorrow. Bye.